Let's start with a random triangle, and then from its sides we will pull three parallel lines in such a way so that they intersect in a single point inside the triangle. As you can see, we have now formed three new inscribed triangles with the areas of 1, 4 and 9. The question is it possible for us to find this red shaded area using only the areas of these three inscribed triangles? If you want to try this interesting problem for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check your solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first we will start with the fact that all the sides of our inscribed triangles are actually formed as parallel lines to the sides of our big triangle. This means that all inner angles of our inscribed triangles are actually equal to the inner angles of our big triangle, which means that all the triangles in our sketch are similar. Now let's remind ourselves about one really interesting property of a triangle similarity. Let's say that we have a triangle with the area A1 and let's label its sides. Then let's say that we have another triangle with the area A2, which is similar to our first triangle. From the triangle similarity, we know that the relation between the corresponding sides of those two triangles must be the same. And this relation is equal to the factor of similarity, which we can label as k. Now, we also know that the relation between their areas must be equal to the squared factor of similarity. In this case, that is k squared. Now, from these two facts, we can conclude that the relation between the sides of those two triangles are actually equal to the relation between the square roots of their areas. We will use this fact in our favor to solve our problem. So let's first label the side of our bottom inscribed triangle as A. Now let's label the corresponding side of our left inscribed triangle as B and the side of our right inscribed triangle as C. As you can see, we can now slide the side A of our triangle to the left and we can do the same with the line C. By doing this, we got the corresponding side of our big triangle, which is equal to the sum of the sides A, B and C. Now, let's have a look at the relation between our big triangle and our three inscribed triangles. First, we will focus at our big triangle and our bottom inscribed triangle. As you already know, those two triangles are similar. So, we know that the relation between their sides is actually equal to the relation between the square roots of their areas. Since we know that the area of the yellow triangle is equal to 9, we can substitute this value and get that this relation is equal to 3 over square root of the area of the big triangle. Now, let's do the same thing for our big triangle and our left inscribed triangle. Those two triangles are also similar, so we will use the same rule. We can say that the relation between their sides is equal to the relation between the square roots of their areas. Since we know that the area of the green triangle is equal to 1, we can substitute this value and get that this relation is equal to 1 over square root of the area of the big triangle. And finally, let's have a look at the big triangle and our right inscribed triangle. Those two are similar as well, so we can use the same rule, and since we know that the area of our blue triangle is equal to 4, we can substitute this value and get that this relation is equal to 2 over square root of the area of our big triangle. Now we have formed three equations. And all that we need to do now is to add those three equations together. By doing this, we will get that a plus b plus c over a plus b plus c is equal to 3 plus 1 plus 2 over square root of the area of the big triangle. Of course, we can simplify this and get the following. From here, we can conclude that square root of the area of the big triangle is equal to 6, and after putting everything to the square, we will get that the area of our big triangle is equal to 36. Now, it's pretty easy for us to find this red shaded area, because this area is equal to the area of our big triangle minus the combined areas of our three inscribed triangles. The green triangle with the area 1, the blue triangle with the area 4, and the yellow triangle with the area 9. Of course, we will now just substitute our values, and we will get the following. From here, we can conclude that our red shaded area is equal to 22 squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. And of course, if you found another way to solve this interesting problem, please write it down in a comment section below. I always love to see your solutions. And as always, until next time, see you all and take care.